Mommy says that she apparently ran out of gas and walked over a mile to the closest gas station. She chose to take her 4-year-old little girl with her, leaving the 2-year-old little boy strapped in a car seat, allegedly asleep. When she gets back, she says the boy is gone. Straight out to Casey McNerney with SeattlePI.com. Casey, thanks for being with us. What can you tell me?
Well, we heard yesterday from police just what you were saying, that the only person who has seen 2-year-old Sky in the last 2 weeks was a neighbor. The neighbor couldn't pin down exactly what day he was last seen. We know that the boy doesn't have a passport, but the mother does. And police have expanded the search to her Kirkland apartment and are also working with the FBI to try and trace him down.
Everyone, you are seeing pictures of baby Sky. He is just 2 years old. To you, Alexis Weed, there's so much background to this case. Mommy has been diagnosed as OCD. And typically, I wouldn't be concerned about that, except the levels we are hearing about, where she wouldn't let anyone sleep on the beds after they had been made because they looked perfect. She wouldn't allow food in the home for periods of time because she thought it was dirty, would not let anyone use the bathroom because she thought that was dirty. Is it true that your research reveals she often threatened that she would not feed the children?
Right, Nancy. This information is coming from court documents that were filed by the father in this bitter divorce case that the couple is having. The father is claiming that she had such severe OCD that she would vacuum in straight lines, that she would not keep food in the cupboards, not keep food in her refrigerator, leaving the kids with no food in the home. He says that he would fear that these kids wouldn't even be fed properly, that she would choose to clean the house rather than feed her kids.
Joining me right now is a special guest, Major Mike Johnson with the Bellevue Police. Major, thank you for being with us.
Good morning. Thank you, Nancy.
Major, what can you tell me about what police have done to find the boy? I mean, I've got twins, and we actually do practice runs where one gets on my back and I hold the other one. One's 50 pounds, one is about 43 pounds. I can still carry each of them in each arm if I have to. Tell me what police are doing to verify her story, if you can.
It's a great point, and one that many parents have mentioned to us in regard to, you know, you make it work. If you have two kids, you need to abandon your vehicle, you make it work, and you take the kids with you. We get that. To the caller's point, the indications are from the search and rescue dogs that, you know, are experts at this kind of thing, that Sky did not climb out of the car and walk away. There's no indication of that, and there's no scent to indicate that that happened.
So, everyone with us, Major Mike Johnson also taking your calls. So that says to me that you have actually used scent dogs, bloodhounds, right?
That's correct. King County Search and Rescue, dozens of them literally were out there Sunday afternoon and evening canvassing that entire area looking for signs of Sky without any luck.
Practically everywhere you go, at red lights, at toll booths, all along the highways, you see those cameras on the highway. Were there cameras in this stretch of road?
There are cameras within the area. What we're trying to pin down right now actively is there some images that were captured between the time she left her apartment in Redmond Sunday morning and the time she arrived to that stretch of highway in Bellevue a short time later. We're canvassing the area. We're searching for every possible option for camera footage that may have been captured along the route that morning, but so far we have nothing.
Major, when she got to the gas station, did she speak to anyone?
She did. She spoke to the attendant at the station, asked for a gas can. She was told that they didn't have one available to give her, and I think it was at about that time that her friend arrived that she had called for help.
Okay, did she call from the Chevron telephone?
Yes, I believe there was a payphone in the area that she used to communicate with her friend, who ultimately called us for help.
This is what I don't understand. Everybody with me, Major Mike Johnson out of Bellevue. She's driving an Acura sports car. I heard that they had an Escalade back at the Target. That's a very expensive Cadillac SUV. They can afford that, but they don't have cell phones, Major? What's that all about?
What mom told us, what Julia told us, was that she had a cell phone, but she left that at home along with her purse that morning.
Well, wait a minute. Wasn't she taking the baby to the hospital, Major?
Yes, that's what she told us.
Well, then where's all the insurance information and the driver's license and all that you got to show at the hospital? You just can't walk in the hospital. I can't anyway. I can't even catch a check without Five Kinds ID, much less go to a hospital.
Well, it's questions like those that have us concerned about Mom's story. You're exactly right.